oppression. Shame is a tool for distracting and silencing. Posters making women seem monstrous and barbaric when we're only doing our best, making difficult decisions according to our own circumstances. Since I shared my story in 2015, I've been having this discussion, and it isn't that divisive. It's not combative like you see on the telly, two warring sides like that. There's a lot of warmth out there. There's a lot of compassion. There's a lot of me too that happened to me. And there are loads of us. So have the conversations. Don't be afraid. Don't let the media narrative of division stop you from having those conversations, because they're there to be had. This is ours to win. 100 years ago in this country, women got the vote. And now, 100 years later, we are going to make history by repealing the Eighth Amendment.
Going on demonstrations, putting up posters and so forth. We were, in fact, doing something, I think, of real historic significance. And I think that's something that we share with Rosa. You are doing something of massive significance, something which is going to change the lives of tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of women. You are making history. Feel really proud of that.
Delivered in Liverpool Women's Hospital on the 4th of March 2017. A victim of Edwards syndrome and a backwards country. Your parents love and miss you.
We found out at a scan that our daughter had no kidneys. She had no fluids found in my womb, so she wasn't protected. We chose to travel to Liverpool Women's Hospital when I was 24 weeks pregnant and induce our labour. For us to have to bring her home to save her the pain and the suffering she was going to endure during the rest of my pregnancy. It was just not right that we had to do that we had to go away.
It's also profoundly hypocritical in that we've had two additional pieces in our constitution giving women the right to travel abroad to obtain what is in their own country a criminal act for which they could go to jail for 14 years. Of that in our own constitution is reason enough to repeal the Eighth.
We have to make that break with that past of dispossession and brutality. The Eighth Amendment is not just an artifact or a relic of something that used to go on. The Eighth is an attempt to keep that past in being.
The Eighth comes from the same root and impulse that gave us industrial schools, Magdalen laundries, and that put children in the hands of those who would meet and frighten them, that kept fear and ignorance where there should have been hope and life. It is part of that old darkness, that stuff that we saw but didn't see. It is in the barbaric tradition of those other barbarities which Irish people in the 21st century have shown that they are overwhelmingly against. That's the message we have to get out. As another speaker said, this is part of that same movement forward. This is not some separate issue about protecting life.
And that's what this rally is about today. It's about asking each one of us to step forward in 2018 and play our part in making history on the 25th of May.
To win abortion rights in Ireland is inspiring to socialists and feminists throughout the United States. The struggle is international. Your fight is our fight, and your victory will be our victory. Repeal the Eighth.